The Story of Israel. In the past in the Middle East, there were many different religions. People often prayed to many gods. There were mountain gods. There were gods of rivers, lakes, and seas. There were all kinds of gods. However, one religion began that worshipped only one god. There was a man named Abram. He was said to be a descendant of both Noah and Adam. He lived in a land called Canaan. There, the God Yahweh made a covenant with Abram. Yahweh promised Abram many descendants and said that the land he was living on would forever be theirs. In return, Abram had to worship only Yahweh. Abram agreed. His name changed to Abraham, which means father of many nations. Abraham's descendants through his son Isaac became the Israelites. Isaac and his wife Rebekah later had twins, Jacob and Esau. Jacob's descendants founded the 12 tribes of the Israelites. They made the city Jerusalem the center of their political power. For a time, they were powerful. Later, they were made slaves and taken to Egypt. And then, many years later, Moses freed the Israelites and returned them to their land.
3. The Story of Israel. In the past in the Middle East, there were many different religions. People often prayed to many gods. There were mountain gods. There were gods of rivers, lakes, and seas. There were all kinds of gods. However, one religion began that worshipped only one god. There was a man named Abram. He was said to be a descendant of both Noah and Adam. He lived in a land called Canaan. There, the god Yahweh made a covenant with Abram. Yahweh promised Abram many descendants and said that the land he was living on would forever be theirs. In return, Abram had to worship only Yahweh. Abram agreed. His name changed to Abraham, which means father of many nations. Abraham's descendants through his son Isaac became the Israelites. Isaac and his wife Rebekah later had twins, Jacob and Esau. Jacob's descendants founded the 12 tribes of the Israelites. They made the city Jerusalem the center of their political power. For a time, they were powerful. Later, they were made slaves and taken to Egypt. And then, many years later, Moses freed the Israelites and returned them to their land.
3. The Story of Israel. In the past in the Middle East, there were many different religions. People often prayed to many gods. There were mountain gods. There were gods of rivers, lakes, and seas. There were all kinds of gods. However, one religion began that worshipped only one god. There was a man named Abram. He was said to be a descendant of both Noah and Adam. He lived in a land called Canaan. There, the god Yahweh made a covenant with Abram. Yahweh promised Abram many descendants and said that the land he was living on would forever be theirs. In return, Abram had to worship only Yahweh. Abram agreed. His name changed to Abraham, which means father of many nations. Abraham's descendants through his son Isaac became the Israelites. Isaac and his wife Rebekah later had twins, Jacob and Esau. Jacob's descendants founded the 12 tribes of the Israelites. They made the city Jerusalem the center of their political power. For a time, they were powerful. Later, they were made slaves and taken to Egypt. And then, many years later, Moses freed the Israelites and returned them to their land.